It affects over 7,000 families each year.
Described as a major health problem, the executive director of the Jamaica Cancer Society says there's just not enough financial support to do what is required.
We would love every year to get a check for $200 million to do all the things that we need to do.
$200 million Jamaican dollars.
$200 million.
I want to be sure we're talking the same language.
Yes, $200 million Jamaican dollars.
What would you do with that?
Well, we would purchase new equipment. We are in need of a mobile mammography machine. And this machine, while it was in its good state, now it has come to the end of its product
cycle. Yes.
Used to provide mammography screening for over 2,000 underserved women across this country. So think about it, with that truck parked there now, these women, well, what we have done in the absence of the truck is to forge partnerships with private radiology center. But you can well imagine what it is costing the Jamaica Cancer Society to transport the women from the community to these private radiology center and to pay these operators to provide the service for these vulnerable women.
CIBC First Caribbean International Bank has again come to the assistance of the Jamaica Cancer Society with its 8th annual Walk for the Cure, scheduled for the Sunday, September 29 at the Hope Botanical Gardens.
We kick off at 6 a.m., usually kicking off with a warm-up session, do the walk. Once we've completed the walk, there'll be obstacle courses. We have a kiddies section where we'll have a bouncer boat to entertain our youngsters.
So everything will be at?
At the park.
So is there, it's not a 5K, 4K, 3K?
It's actually approximately 3Ks. Mm-hmm. So we do two laps around Hope Botanical Park. And that will amount to 3K in totality.
And one of the regional sponsors, BH Paints, is also on board in more ways than one. As the HR manager herself is a surviving cancer victim.
Early detection for me is a plus and a must. One other thing, I discovered a lump on self-examination. And upon that discovery, I immediately went to, because I was always doing my mammogram every year. And so I was already scheduled to do one, but I found the lump before. And so I went and did the works of the mammogram. They were, you know, not too clear. And then they send you on another process to get it a little clearer, out, or ultrasound, you know, get all of that thing going. I can tell you, fast forward, last year when they told you the C word, I think this is cancer. They kind of fixed it up for you because they're not sure how you're going to receive it.
Yes.
And that word came into play. For me, it was a lot of feelings coming together. I mean, I am a mother of three children. I have a lot going on. You know, you did the self-check. You did what you're supposed to be doing. You don't smoke. You don't drink. All of this thing that you think you're eating all healthy and stuff. And all of that came to bear. So when this comes, immediately feelings of, you know, depression, the feeling of anxiety, feeling all sorts come to mind. It is at really a difficult time because you're thinking about finance and you can't hide the finances part of it because it's very expensive.
Michael Sharp, Frontline News.